Hi, KT.
Hi there.
With all the turbulence in the markets, everyone's wondering, when will markets hit bottom? You published a new piece of research on this yesterday. To give us some context, how do we know when a market trough is temporary or more lasting?
That's a great question. Often you only know in hindsight. There's a lot of news coming out on the infections, on the virus, on the policy response. So a temporary bounce can happen at any time. But as analysts and investors, you do want to know when you have conditions in place for a lasting bounce or a lasting bottom in markets. And that's what we identify in our research report. We lay out a number of conditions. It includes a flattening out in the infection rate curve, some visibility on the depth and duration of the actual hit to economic activity, a mitigation of other risks, including funding stresses, liquidity stresses, political stresses, and some deep undervaluation of asset markets. The core insight here is really that markets can only bottom once they are able to limit the distribution of tail risks that they have to price. So you often tend to see recoveries once that can be done, once you can limit the amount of tail risks, even before the data on the recovery is actually visible.
And is there any one indicator that you're looking for to see that markets are starting to hit a bottom? And if so, what is that?
One of the key things we found in our previous research, also looking at market bottoms in past recessions, is that different parts of the market and different indicators bottom at different times. Take the global financial crisis as an example. Most of the Fed's programs to deal with funding stresses were already in place in November 2008. The Chinese fiscal stimulus kicked in around the same time. And so assets levered to those bottomed already at that point. Equity wall peaked early on as well. However, the broader DM and US economic recovery didn't play out until March 09, and that's when you saw a broad lasting recovery from a broad lasting trough across asset markets. I think we are likely to see something very similar this time. Policy authorities, Fed and others have been very quick to attack the funding stresses, the liquidity stresses that have been in the system. I think we could see some of the assets levered to that bottom earlier, but for a broader market trough, I think you do need more visibility on the depth and the duration of the hit to the broader economy.
Thanks, KT.
Thank you.